Welcome to Bulwick Hall. We came here in 2002, and over the last 17 or 18 years, we've been quite daunted by this garden, but we've done a lot of work to it to change different areas that were a bit tired or overgrown. The garden itself is attributed to Humphrey Repton, who worked in Norfolk and is actually buried in Aylsham Church, which is just about a mile up the road from here. So the garden has various features that suggest that Repton might have been involved in it, even though there's no red book to definitively show that he was. But there are things like a lake that bends round so that it looks like it's much bigger than it really is. There's a vegetable garden that's surrounded by trees rather than by a wall. And various other features, particular sorts of planting and evergreens, which are really old, and a big yew hedge. So I'm going to give you a little tour around the garden, pointing out a few of the interesting features. So I'll start this little tour in the gravel area. There's a gorgeous tree peony just on my right here with its amazing cup-shaped yellow flowers that have just opened up with the sunshine we've been having. This whole area used to have a lot of hybrid tea roses, which were rather past their best, and so it's become a slightly Japanese inspired gravel area now. We found these huge rocks in a former rockery bed and sighted those in the gravel. There are some nice plants that we've put in. There's Heffalaria, which comes up a bit later in the year. It's just starting to emerge. There's rosemary, and at the moment I can smell the amazing scent of these curry plants that are just over here. There's a big area of them. It smells like somebody's cooking. And they have a really pretty yellow flower later on in the year. And then looking over in this direction, there's the gorgeous pale pink, almost white but flushed with pink, rhododendron Loderi King George over there, and cherry trees behind. That area used to be absolutely chock-a-block with laurel, which we took out, and it's now an area for espalier apples and a few cherry trees. So we'll now continue out of the gravel area. Into what we call the shrub border, which we've planted up with quite a few azaleas and rhododendrons. This is a lovely one. And then moving on along the shrub border towards the yew hedge. Lots of scented plants along here, which is really nice if you come to visit at this time of year. And there are the apple espaliers in full bloom over there. Hopefully we'll get lots of apples later in the year. So continuing on, beyond the yew hedge, we'll come into the vegetable garden and the herbaceous area. So that was laid out when the garden was first planned. So this yew hedge is absolutely huge. It's really, really thick. It has to be cut once a year, and the rest of the year it actually survives quite well. Except this year we had a tree fall on part of it. There used to be a huge poplar over to the right, and sadly we had a couple of branches come off it, and then the whole thing had to be felled. But it did quite a bit of damage to the hedge, as you can see as we walk down. So we're going to turn into the left here, and there's the herbaceous area. And when we arrived here, there was a vegetable garden both sides, but we actually reduce that to just the left hand side, and on the right hand side we planted apples. And as we go down to the end of the herbaceous border, we can look over towards the lakeside walk. So this will take us right round the pond or lake. It used to be a mill pond because Bulwick Mill was quite a significant mill in Norfolk and was still operating up until the 1960s. So now we're looking across to the boathouse and the Mermaid Stream, which feeds our mill pond. And if we look across the pond or lake, past the swans that are nesting on the little island over there, there's the old mill house. And visitors can walk all the way around the lake and emerge onto the lawn here and then have their tea on the terrace. This year we've been working on various elements around the garden during the winter. So one of those is the summer house, which actually came from a TB hospital up on the North Norfolk coast. Here's the summer house, which since lockdown I've redecorated. It was badly in need of it, so it's been a great opportunity. It's a lovely place to sit and read. And the dog really likes it as well.